meteorologist Matt Engelbrecht joining us now. Matt, you've been talking about some dangerous heat for much of the nation's midsection.
Yeah, we looked at that just a little bit ago, and it's that transition from the dangerous heat to some cooler, drier air that could spark severe weather later on this afternoon. A slight risk once again, and the same area has been under the threat for severe weather going back the last 2 to 3 days. Again, so a slight risk, portions of Illinois into Indiana, even southwest Michigan, back here to Missouri. Potential for some strong thunderstorms to move through. Now, that's not the only thing that we're tracking, the severe weather, but also what's going on in the tropics. Fred has officially formed, officially been named, and over the next couple of days, expected to organize and strengthen into a tropical storm as it moves closer to the coast of Florida by Friday and into Saturday. So this line right here, that is Saturday. Winds at about 45 miles per hour with a good amount of rainfall. Now, the other thing I've included in this, it's tough to see, these little lines, the colored lines right there, that's the spaghetti plot. We've been looking at that the last couple of days, very tightly packed. In fact, all of them are within the cone of uncertainty, meaning there's high confidence in where this circulation is going over the next 72 hours or so. Now, let's look at that tropical update. You'll see it towards the tail end of this loop. Some of that moisture come in into southern parts of Florida. Otherwise, back up where that severe weather potential, that slight risk has been highlighted for the afternoon, right over the same areas we've been tracking the last couple of days. Some rain also possible back out here to the west where we certainly need it, but that scorching heat into Oregon and Washington is certainly going to make for very dry conditions. That includes parts of the Dakotas as well. What's going on with the jet stream is we have a weak trough trying to dig down from the north to the south. With that, there is a cold front attached, which is what we're talking about with that cooler, drier air coming in and the severe weather potential for this afternoon. Next Monday looks a little bit better in terms of a low pressure system developing a mid-latitude cyclone, if you want to get fancy with it, across the nation and sparking more showers, but also a contrast in temperatures next Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, which should help break the heat for a good portion of the nation where it needs it. Now, it's going to get pretty shallow by next Thursday and Friday, but certainly some relief coming over parts of Montana, as well as what we've been mentioning, Oregon and Washington. There's a look at that jet stream. Nashville, Tennessee, hot and steamy. Heat advisory in effect, high of 99, low of 75. Aberdeen, Oklahoma, sunny and dry, breezy, 81 over 51. And Lacey, Washington, near Olympia, hot, excessive heat warning.